president of the Lakeshore Players Board of Directors. Just a little bit of business before we get started. In case of an emergency, please note the exits are on either side of the stage and also back through the doors that you came in. Also, there will be a 20-minute intermission where you can visit our bar and have a couple of drinks. And don't forget to buy your half and half tickets. At the end of the show, if you like, we will be having a meet and greet with the cast and crew. We'll be serving wine and a light buffet, courtesy of Snowden Deli. So just one other note, volunteers are the backbone of community theater. So if you have an interest in theater, please check out our Facebook page, please check out our website, or you can email me, vicepresident@lakeshoreplayersdorval.com, and we'll let you know how you can get involved. So please, everyone, just sit back and relax and enjoy the comedy of tennis.
What did you say again? I didn't hear that.
Well, I'm a singer, and you gave me a chance
nights, and now I have a career, but we have a concert tonight in less than 3 hours, and I have to go back to rehearsal.
And I want you to go back to rehearsal. Just as soon as you make sure the toilets aren't filthy, and you make sure there's no more underwear lying on the floor, and then get that jackass in over early.
I'm giving you 3 minutes, but then I have to go. Oh, bonjour. We're expecting Tito Morelli and his wife, and they're arriving on
Transatlantic Flight 102 from Rome.
Transatlantic Flight 102 from Rome. And we're wondering if the plane is late. Merci. Here, hold this. I'm going to check the bedrooms.
Can you imagine Tito Morelli in France? I guess he'd be at the Folies Bergère drinking champagne out of some filthy slipper.
That's not fair.
You know what's riding on this? My entire reputation's at stake.
Yes, I know that, sir. Well, that one's fine. The bed looks nice.
Oh, the bed. That's all he needs. You could lie in the bed and have sex with the maid and maybe be late for the concert, eh?
You shouldn't be so hard on him, sir. He's been a really good friend to me, and I think he's going through a sort of personal crisis.
Oh, poor thing. Is he off his linguine? He can't drink his gaffy fast enough?
Well, I think he's starting to feel his age. I mean, he's almost as old as some of the opera singers who are still performing.
Really feeling your roast there, eh, Max? Old man Sanders, over the hill, is that the idea?
No, I didn't mean that.
Max, I fought hard for this. I fought for 30 years for this. And now I'm producing the biggest show in the history of art.
Yes, I'm still here. Oh, good. Oh, thank you. Merci. His plane landed 30 minutes ago, so he should be here any minute. Now I have to go because they're waiting for me.
If I get through this week without having a heart attack, you'll see a miracle like that. What's this? My God. They might as well put up a sign, "Welcome to France, fornication and progress." Stop horsing around. Wait till you see this, Max. Stop stuttering! You You wouldn't think of the French as stutterers, and yet. What? Quit. You see, going, just quit. Okay. I'll fix it, John. I'll fix it. Calm down. Calm down before I strangle you.
There is a problem?
No. That's just a little exercise we do just in case there ever was one. And help handle it brilliantly. Well, I think I must be off to make sure that everything is running smoothly. And the machine is in gear and broom are out.
Getting old over here. The stars fade, the delights go out.
That's from La Bohème.
So what? That's not the point. It used to be the girls at the stage door, they were 4D, right? I sign autograph, they want a hug. Oh, Tito, we want a picture. Oh, we love you, Tito. Everybody wants a kind of nooch.
No!
Now we're young, maybe. 10 years old. I hear my own voice singing in the church. And it was beautiful. And I knew it was from God. And I say, thank you, God. You're a good man. After that, I sing everywhere, eh? Every opera house, every concert. I become a big star. But then, maybe 6 months ago, I never tell you this. I'm singing in Donizetti. And my voice is crack over the high C. Just the ones. With everybody in the place, they look at me and they say, oh, you get to know. It's a goodbye, Tito. I cannot live like this without respect and honor!
That's from that book,
guys. Maria!
Tito, you gotta stop! I'm giving you pride!
Pride? I'm being tortured in the dungeon!
That's from Bosca!
Oh, would you stop me?
Tito, it's in your head. Your voice is as good as ever. On the stage, you've got a heart. You've got a soul. You still eat like a pig, but that's not Hey, nothing has changed. Except maybe you forget something now and then.
I forget it? Me? Like what?
It's another point. It makes no difference.
No, you tell me. I forget it. You tell me.
It's my birthday.
Today?
Yeah.
Today is your birthday.
Yeah.
Madre mia.
Yeah.
Maybe that'll explain why I carry this bag around. Oh, no. Oh, maybe that explains why I carry this bag around.
Tito?
Oh, yes, I forget it so much.
Look at this, you remember. I open now, yes?
No, you wait till the next Tuesday or Wednesday.
You're very funny. I like a bingo crawl. Oh, it's a star. It's lovely. It's beautiful.
Very.
Excellent.
Hey, you want to celebrate? We got the bed, eh?
Ah, we just got here. We don't have real luggage yet.
You need the luggage to make a lot?
Might help. Cousins are there.
Okay, fine. Who get it?
Hey, no, don't be like this.
Like what? I'm fine. I need to lay down anyway to take a nap. For old people, we need to rest.
People.
You want the other man? You just gotta say so.
Hey, you're the best man I know, okay? And when our daughter gets a husband, I will be just like you.
What's Mimi got to do with this?
Nothing, I'm just saying.
Mimi gets a husband in 5 years, 10 years. She's just a baby.
She's a 25 years old.
Okay, 15 years.
She's old. She's a little woman. She's got the gorgeous.
Sure. When she hits puberty, you call
her. Tito, she's a past puberty, eh? She's up to gorgeous.
But that's impossible. We sent her to boarding school in the United States so she could be a good girl and not have the gorgeous.
She's not, I believe
you. How do you know this? Are you so smart?
Because she talked to me, I'm her mother.
I And I'm an uncle father?
What's the difference?
What's the difference, eh? My sister, she talk about oranges with my papa all of the time.
Your sister's only oranges will drive me crazy.
But she talk about it.
It's not the kind of orange I'm talking to people. Women have needs, sometimes more than you think.
More than I think? What, hey, maybe you got a man on the side for all the year.
Okay,
hey, maybe you two men, eh? For urge one and urge two, because apparently I'm not doing so good on number three.
Don't change the subject.
I'm not changing the subject. The subject is me, my daughter, my life. We still baby. And if any man even touch her, I'm gonna kill her. And now, I'm gonna have a nap. Thank you.
You're not so bad yourself.
Ciao.
Can just walk out on us anytime?
Well, that's not exactly how I would describe it.
I'll sue the bastard for his next herring allotment.
Sir?
He'll sing his next Don Carlo in his underwear at the Spot on Line Apple and Stone Door Company.
Sir, his mother died.
His mother died? Excuse me. Am I missing something? Don't mothers die every day? Doesn't everybody die? Whoop! It's 3 o'clock, there goes mom. Whoop, it's 3 o'clock. Oh, grandma just hit the button. Does that mean anything to you?
Sir, he said he was sorry. He knew it would cause inconvenience.
Inconvenience, is that what this is?
No, I understand that.
Oh! We've had a little inconvenience.
Sir, he's in mourning.
Well, he must be. Probably going back to his Viking ancestors so he can set fire to his mother's boat. Good job. We'll have to change the advertising. We'll call it the two tens, the years and now. Yes, it looks like UC Yorling is not coming back here, yes. Apparently he's a mama's boy. Well, you know the Swedes, Charles. Courage is not their hallmark, is it? Now, I want you to call every agent in Paris and see by a miracle if you can get a replacement for the Count of Copenhagen.
That's Denmark, sir.
Good job. We have 2 hours and 40 minutes. You have mastered the watch face after all. Now, I want you to get me a singer, preferably a tenor. I'd like him alive, but if you can't, I'll take a baritone, a soprano, or any good dick, but just get somebody up here.
Sir, I'm sure you'll find somebody in time.
Oh, how optimistic. Is that the same way in which the same spirit in which you impregnated my only daughter?
Sir, she's my wife.
Don't come back.
Sorry, Henry.
And now, she's wandering around like a duck back in Cleveland. Well, you couldn't control yourself? Well, let me just tell you something. You treat her nice. Keep her safe. You make her happy and treat her like a queen. That is the secret to a good marriage. I know, I've been married 4 times. Yes or no? Job? Stop stuttering. Speak. What? Really? That's great, honestly. That's fantastic. Sure, I'll be with him. I'll be right down.
What happened?
Thank the gods of commerce.
What?
Job, you're gonna lead on the third tenor. First call, just like that. I love that boy. Now, I want you to stay here with this stupendo alcoholic, just in case he gets a taste for his favorite Chianti.
But my rehearsal.
I'll forget about your rehearsal. I want you to stay here with Tito, make sure he's alive, sober, and in his touch by 6 o'clock. Or I'm firing you. Now stay here.
Bye.
friend, Max. He's going to have a friend.
Tina, what happened?
Oh, it's nothing. It's just the marriage.
What happened?
Maria, she's unfaithful to me.
Maria?
No. Yes.
It's impossible.
It's true.
I don't believe it for a second.
Maria's unfaithful to me.
Tito, how do you know?
I saw them.
You saw them? You actually saw them?
It was more like the...
Oh, that wasn't...
No, not exactly. But I was watching. They talk about their big love, their big muscle. He's young, he's a vital. She said he's a thing, make her happy.
Oh my God!
I can't believe it. After all of these years, we worked so hard on this life together. Now, it's like a darkness come inside me. It's like a nightmare.
No, I don't believe it for a second. You must have misunderstood something.
Never.
Oh, come on, of course you did. I mean, maybe she flirted with somebody. I'm not saying that she did, but you know how it is. We all do it now and then. It's natural. I mean, I bet you've done the same thing, but you've never gotten serious with another woman.
I did. What?
You did?
Before Maria and I were married.
Before? That hardly qualifies as an affair, you know.
But it was crazy because I was crazy, mad in love with Maria.
What happened?
I was swept away. It was the famous soprano, the great Raccoon.
Tatiana Raccoon?
Tatiana Rocco.
Holy cow. She's incredible. She's here in Paris this week doing Salome at the Carnegie.
She is from Russia. She was so gentle and had such a deep emotion. She could be laughing and crying all at the same time. We spent one night here together in Paris while Maria was waiting for me in Vienna. I was unfaithful. Now she is unfaithful. I have buried myself in my own tomb.
That's from Aida.
That's not the point!
Oh, that's Mr. Saunders. Now listen, Maria did nothing wrong. Just remember that. We both know.
We,
huh? Max, wait till it is. Hey, Tito, how's it going? How's your wife? I'm getting a clock, So, guess what happened?
I don't know, but it sounds like it's good news.
It's good. Better believe it.
Oh, did we get UC back?
UC back?
I thought so.
No, we didn't get UC back. Who needs the bastard?
We got the stakes. We're flying to the big boys.
No, you know, in fact, I think we owe UC Balling something.
Let's send him some flowers. It was his mother who died.
Yes, sir.
Now, guess who's singing with you two in the concert room?
Lawrence Melchior.
Nope. Ettore Tallarico.
Oh!
Better. Younger.
Younger? Oh my God, it isn't.
Yeah. Oh yes, it is. It's Carlo Nucci. And here he is.
Just a minute. It was him!
I tell you!
Tito!
I'm not the crazy!
But you could be mistaken!
No!
So, you saw them?
Yeah.
But you didn't see them
there. That's a lot, Max! Oh, Max! It was like a nightmare. She came in with a scarf that I gave her this morning for her birthday, and I chose it to myself. It's like that she gave my heart, my love,
my kidney. You're sure about this?
I was walking.
And where did this happen?
In there.
So you were watching him through the door?
See.
And where were you just before that?
On the balcony, watching the naked girl run across the field.
There was a naked girl running across the field?
Si.
Did you recognize her?
Si. She looked something like my daughter Mimi. Or Mrs. Rosa.
And where were you just before the naked girl episode?
On the bed.
Asleep?
Yeah.
Tito! You were having a dream. Yes. Here, listen to me. Don't worry about me getting married. You and Maria, you have a fight, an argument. You lie down and you fall asleep. Then you have this dream. Where you see a naked girl who looks just like your daughter. And then, through a door, you see your wife having an affair with a man who's 20 years younger than you, and Tito. And then, he turns out to be your biggest rival. Tito, it was a dream, it had to be.
This is impossible.
Tito, I took a psychology course. It's a whole new field. Have you heard of Sigmund Freud? Well, he wrote this book. It's called The Interpretation of Dreams. And seeing a naked girl run across a soccer field while your wife is helping your biggest rival get dressed through an invisible door, Tito, you will be in the sequel if you aren't locked up first.
But it all seems so real. And it had everything that keep me up at night. Seeing women, age, sex. My daughter, women, sex.
Tito, you owe Carl an apology. And can I tell you the truth? Well, for me, this concert is it's a really big deal. I mean, I know I'll never sing like you, but I could have a good career, and this concert could take that to a whole new level. And well, with the baby coming.
How are you, man?
Oh, she's due next week, and here I am being an artist while she's.
I know this feeling.
Yeah.
Okay. I do this for you. We do the concert.
Really? All right. Thank you, Tito. You're the best. Let's tell them. Gentlemen, you can come in now.
Well, I made a mistake.
Yeah, you sure did.
I'm sorry. Here's my hand.
Really? Oh, good. I mean, I can understand if you're upset about it.
No. You're a good singer. You have a beautiful voice.
But not like yours.
No.
You're my idol. I wanted to meet you my whole life.
No.
I swear to God, I'm from Brooklyn, my parents are Italian, and all my father ever talked about was Tito Merelli. On the radio, we heard you in Rigoletto, and my God, we just sat there with tears in our eyes. You're the best there is.
Perhaps I miss a job.
You know who will be performing at Salviati in the concert?
Filippiano.
Of course.
Hey, wait a second. Why don't we rehearse it?
Now?
Why not? We're all here and we have to assign the lines anyway.
Thanks for me.
Si, where are we on?
Great, that's right. Okay, so just stand here. Good. Now, we just have to picture that out there, is a huge audience. Thousands of people, and they've all come to hear us sing. And so the announcer, he goes to the microphone, and he looks looks over at the audience. Bonsoir, mesdames et messieurs. C'est un plaisir que vous présente les trois canards. I took French in college. S'il vous plaît, applaudissez. I'm sorry, I was just. S'il vous plaît, applaudissez le canard Max. Et le chanteur célébré, Carlo Nucci. Et finalement, le plus grand star de le firmament, le grand chanteur Tito Marbelli. Now, Tito always says to hear the music, it's in our heads. Listen.
Because Because I saw the two of you together right here. You think you can hide these things from me?
Tito, listen up. He's a nice young boy. He's a hot pepper, eh? I'm crazy about him.
Max, you're a good man. You're You're loyal, you're honest, and you're going to be the father of my grandchild. But you don't know how tough I had it. I was born in Akron, Ohio. Can you imagine what that was like? T.S. Eliot wrote The Wasteland, thinking about Akron, Ohio. The town had one piano, and they used it as a planter. But I said, no, this will not be the life ahead of me. This will not define who I am. I wanted music. I wanted culture. I wanted to bring opera to the people. And now, when I get my chance to fulfill my dreams, Max, I need a tenor. I need a tenor!